Good morning and welcome back to the channel. It's a very exciting day. Today we are leaving beautiful South Korea and going to...
the Philippines! Country number 10.
So this is the situation right now. The room is a disaster and we have to get our bags under 10 kilograms or it's $200 to check our bags. So that is the mission right now. And got a new hat. Thanks for noticing.
Finally!
Okay, we did it. Both of our bags are under 10 kilograms, and now we're gonna go check out, except we have about 10 hours until our flight leaves. So I'm gonna go get a haircut. We're gonna go look at some sandcastles, and then we're gonna check out hopefully two airport lounges. And then we get into the Philippines around 1 a.m., and we're gonna sleep in these cool space pods. Okay, so right now we're in Busan, South Korea, which is the second biggest city in South Korea, and it's right by the beach, and we're gonna go show you that now. Okay, we made it to the beach and we got our coffee. This is probably our last Korean coffee. Aww. Every time we leave a country, I just get so sad. So you'll probably hear me say the same thing when we're about to leave the Philippines.
And for the first week or so we're in the Philippines, he's gonna be saying, I wish we were in Korea right now. I miss Korea. Korea's the best.
South Korea is the best. Everyone should come here. Okay, and one more thing, because this will be hilarious later. We have no idea how we're getting from our hotel tonight to our hotel on the other side of Cebu Island. So I think it's funny how we're both way more relaxed than we didn't plan. And just wait till later when the plan falls through and we're stuck somewhere.
We don't even know how we're getting from our airport to our hotel tonight at 1 in the morning.
Yeah. I think we'll walk. And is it Cebu or Subu? Cebu.
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 People get very mad if you say their city's wrong, I've heard.
I don't know.
Okay. Cebu.
Someone will let us know in the comments, I'm
yeah.
sure.
Okay, we're back. And don't worry, Shae didn't get a new husband. It's still me. I just got a haircut and the beard is off.
Whole new man yeah. I'm married to.
And now what do we have?
Honeycomb ice cream. We don't know if we should eat the honeycomb or not, but I guess we'll try.
Yeah.
So you can eat the honeycombs, but they don't taste very good. They taste like a cigarette wrapped in honey. It's super weird.
How would you know what that tastes like?
That's just how I imagine it, a cigarette would taste.
We're gonna explore these beautiful sand sculptures and then go to the airport. So we'll see you there. Well, that's awkward. That's my name, and this is what the thing looks like. Hey guys, we made it to the airport, and in usual Shae and David fashion, we're here way too early. To be exact, we're 4 hours early.
Like, extra early, because we thought we could go to two different lounges and have lots of time to relax and eat, but turns out you can't even check in until 3 hours before your flight, so now we're just
waiting around.
Waiting around for an hour.
But ask and you shall receive. We went to the check-in counter anyways, and I said, hey, can we have better seats? And she gave us the exit row for a 4.5 hour flight, so not too bad.
Yeah.
So now we're waiting for an hour. We're not gonna buy anything because we're going in the lounge where everything's free, and we'll check back in then. And I'm still really sad to be leaving Korea. Okay, it is about 1.5 hours later. We made it into the lounge, but not before they searched my bag and took my little multi-tool because apparently the flathead screwdriver was a couple centimeters too long. And then we also figured out we need an onward ticket from the Philippines to our next destination, and the airline made us sign a waiver saying we promised to leave the Philippines. But all is well, we made it into the lounge, and then we just spent an hour filling out the Filipino arrival declaration, which was very complicated. But now we have some food and dessert, and we're just waiting to board our flight.
Hi. landed in Cebu, Philippines.
It's 2 in the morning.
Yeah.
And we are going to go to sleep and we'll show you our space pod tomorrow. Let's go. So we get into the room, which has all the pods, and this is the nice hotel lady who's showing us how the pod works. And inside the pod here, we can see we have a flat screen TV. We have a mirror over there, and the pod is currently set to nighttime mode, so it looks like a spaceship. And then over here, we have the control panel, where you have things so you can charge all your devices. You have different buttons so you can turn all the lights off. You have an alarm clock. So it's pretty cool, and overall, a really comfortable night, minus a little bit of snoring from above. Good morning from beautiful Cebu, Philippines. We just finished our sleep in those cool space pods. And now we're going to go to the front desk, check out. We have to get cash, get breakfast, go to the bus terminal, and take a 5-hour bus over to Oslob. So wish us luck. We still don't know how we're doing it. What'd you think of the sleep last night?
I was really uncomfortable, honestly.
What? I was comfortable.
You were?
Yeah, there's just people snoring. But
even though your back hurts today?
Well, I'm just an old man, that's fine. Oh, well, let's get to a hotel. This is why we don't stay in hostels. First impressions of the Philippines, everyone speaks really good English and they're all super nice, so we're looking forward to it.
Thank you so much. Have a good day.
Can you tell us where to get a bus to Oslob?
Oslob.
Is that the south bus terminal?
Yes, sir. And okay. Then from here, it's only like a taxi going to south bus. And then in south bus, there's an option van or bus going there.
Okay. What's better? The van?
I think, van.
Yeah?
Mm-mm.
Okay.
Yeah, because bus, it keeps stopping, so it will consume more time. But
okay.
Just check if the van, is, you have backpack, so I think van is... The space also is the problem.
Okay. Awesome.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Stops along the way, and we just told them we're going to where they do the whale sharks in Oslob, and they know exactly where we're going, and we're just at
the mercy of the
Philippines, so yeah. We're excited. You can also choose between a seat that a bus that has AC or a bus that doesn't.
I don't know why anyone would choose a bus that does not have air conditioning. Yeah. It's so hot.
And we're ready to go.
Okay. So hopefully it's a fun bus ride.
Yeah. Everything's gonna work out.
Yeah.
Stay tuned to see if it does.
It usually always does.
Usually.
We made it to our hotel in Oslob.
After a 5-hour grueling bumpy ride on the local bus, we've made it.
We thought it would be like 2 to 3 hours, but it was a long ride.
There was a lot of stops. But we made it to the hotel and we're getting up at 3 a.m. tomorrow to go see the whale sharks. We're very excited. And we paid 1,000 Filipino pesos. We just have to be downstairs at 3 a.m. and then we get to go do the whale shark thing.
So exciting.
So we'll see you tomorrow and wish us luck. Thanks for watching.